Hello friends, today we are going to discuss about the execute macro, some advanced features that we'll cover in this video. Okay, the previous video we covered all the basic features like calling a macro from UIPath. Okay, in this video we'll cover some advanced features. Okay, so if you see here, there are two kinds of things that is available. Okay, that in the previous video we only discussed till here calling a macro. Okay, in this there are two features that are also available, like macro parameter. That means we are giving a parameters as an input to the macro, and macro output. That means whatever the macro is returning, the value that we can get it in UIPath, and we can use that in other flows. Okay, so let's see our scenarios. What is the agenda for today is, like, I'll create a macro with parameters, and I'll send these parameters from UIPath, and I will display the result. Okay, so let's get into our Excel sheet and create a macro. Okay, so if you see here, I have created a macro here, that is a test one, which we are giving two values, name and name one, name and name two. Okay, here there are two kinds of things will be there, by value and by address. By value and by address, two kind of passing mechanisms will be there. Here I am using only by value, since we are only sending the value, we are not dealing with address. Okay, so once I got that, and I am displaying the message box saying name and name one. Okay, so let's get into this, and let's call our macro from UIPath. This is a test one, is a macro name. So what I'll do is, I'll just edit this one, test one, and here if you see here, they are saying is enumeration objects. Okay, so what I'll do is, I'll pass those values in enumerator type. So here I'm giving as Karthik, and another one as UIPath. Okay, and I'm just creating that one here. Okay, so save this, and here, yeah, that would be enough. Here the message box, that is not required as of now, this should be enough. Okay, I'm running this macro now, and you can see that got generated, and it is showing like our user ID, and the value that we got is like hello UIPath listeners, then the value that is a user ID, that is my name is Karthik, that is displayed here, and name 2 is also displayed UIPath that we have sent. Okay, and if I click on OK, then that it will get closed. Okay, and why I got this exception is, this is exception is in the message box because I haven't initialized anything here. So what I'll do is, I'll just give the initialization here. Here what I am doing is, here I am just displaying this result. So I am not using that result variable now. Maybe in a 2 minutes we'll use that one as well. So as of now, I'm just sending the parameters only. Okay, so let me execute this macro one more time and see how it is coming. See, you can see that is coming properly if I click OK, and that is message box, that is the last one. This is the message box, it's been running here. Okay, now let's see why I have created this message box and how we can use that here. Okay, so here once I send this path, now let's work with another one, like getting the value from the macro and using that as part of the message, as part of the our UIPath workflow. Okay, so for that purpose only I have created this result variable, and I am displaying that value. Okay, now we'll see the usage here. Okay, so the function, the macro which return a value from an Excel, will always be a function. Okay, there are two kinds of macros that is possible in Excel, that is one is function, other one is sub. Sub will never return a value. Okay, whereas function will always return a value, and you have to make sure that the function name and the passing variable, that passing variable should be same. Here you can see the test 2 and test 2 should be same, then only it will return something. That means it is, the value is there in test 2 variable, and that will be used by some other application. Here it is UIPath. Okay, so I am calling that one here. So I am calling this test2. I am sending that parameters here. See, you can see here there are two, by value name and name one. So that is I am sending here, and I am creating an output of that. That means this macro will get this parameter name and name two, and it is sending it to test2, and this test2 value will be caught in here macro output. I don't have to create anything here, is already available. So I'll just give this result. Okay, so you can see result is an object type because you don't know exactly what value you are getting. Okay, so once you get here, I'm just displaying that value here. Okay, so if you observe previously, we got exception and we got a blank message box because of RES result value is not having anything here. Okay, so if you observe properly, I am giving this my function name, that is Excel macro name. I am sending the parameters, I am getting the value in the result, and I am displaying it in here. Okay, so let's go and run this function, and now you can see that it's now running it. Now you can see that message box is displaying my name, which I have given, and the second parameter is UIPath. If I click OK, that means that got closed. So I hope you people understood the importance of these parameters, because with these macro parameters, you can dynamically change the values. Here we have given this in static. You can create other variables in a UIPath, and you can send those values, and you can get the values in output as well, and you can use as part of the UIPath other workflows. Okay, you can use that you can use the same thing in this workflow, and sometimes you can use other workflows as well by calling other invoke method file like that. Okay, that is a bit advanced concept. Okay, and that is not part of the in the scope of this video here. So if I can summarize this, I am using Excel macro activity, and this Excel macro activity should be used as part of Excel application scope only. Then you have to put that macro in module only. If you put it inside the sheet and the workbook, this macro will not get recognized, and you can get that, you can send the parameters using macro parameters, and you can get the value of the macro using macro output, and you can use this as part of the workflow. Okay, so I hope you guys understood clearly. If you have any doubt, please put it in the comment section so that I can come back to you guys. Okay, thank you. I'm Karthik, signing off.